Okay. Hello, let's get started. So today we will do the lab for working with Java Database Connectivity, JDBC. And instead of working with a huge database like Oracle or MySQL or Postgre, we are going to work with SQLite. If in any time my voice is fading, please let me know and I'm going to change the connection over the GSM. Okay. Okay, so let's get started. File new. And then we have here Java project. And here in Java project, we are in week 13, S13, okay, underscore JAPP, underscore JDBC, Java Database Connectivity. We leave it with Java 11, 13, whatever Java Standard Edition we have, at least 8 we must have. And then next. And here, I don't want to create a module. We are going to discuss modules in the next lecture, not on this Friday, but the last one. And then finish when we are discussing reactive streams as well. So in here, we have the sources. And in the sources, we are going to create, for instance, a package and in the same time a class. And left click, right click, new. And with this class wizard, we are going to hit two things. First is the name of the package, which you may already customize with it, is eu.asa.jdbc, whatever, SQLite, SQLite, JDBC SQLite, so, right? Okay, the name of the class is going to be progmain SQL, one single L, Lite. I'm checking public static void main and now finish. And finally, I have the class. Is anybody who cannot see the font size? Is good enough, I think, for everybody, right? Please let me know if otherwise. So here I'm going to import all the classes and interfaces when I'm working with the database via JDBC are in this non-optional package, so in Java package, dot SQL, structured query language. And in here, I have a lot of things. So as you can see, if I'm putting dot, yes, I'm going to include all of them, but I have connection, which is interface. I have driver, which is interface. So there is no implementation in here. I'm going to explain immediately. So star, I want to mainly import all the interfaces. When I have told you in the lecture number 2 or 3, that the interfaces and interfaces type concept in Java and in C sharp as well is used mainly for standardization. We have seen first standardization in the Java collection framework, right? I have list interface, but then the real class could be array list, could be vector, whatever other real class implementation. Here as well, I have interface connection. And the real implementation depends from the database vendor to database vendor, from MySQL, PostgreSQL, Oracle, SQL server from Microsoft, and so on. So all the database servers till the, what we are working today, SQLite, which is a very light form of an engine which is interpreting SQL 92. So this being said, let's move forward. And in this main, we are going to say, con from connection, connect, control space, and please. And here I'm going to choose this connection, right? And this connection from here is going to be C equal, right? And from drive manager, so control space, drive man, okay? Then I'm going to call the static method as a factory, dot, for instance, get connection. Here, this string is the URL, universal resource locator, exactly like in location in the internet. This is different from database to database. So therefore, I'm going to say in here, string URL equals, and between quotes, I'm going to put what I need, JDBC, 2 points, then SQLite, then 2 points, and then test.db, sorry, just give me a few moments. Let's continue. So in here, as you can see, I have what? I have this part of the string URL, as you can see. This is different from database to database. Additionally, I will do the following. So I need upfront to say something like class, this is reflection, dot for name, right? I'm going to put in here the class which is providing for me the driver connection. So I would say something like org.sqlite.jdbc, right? So I have something like this. As you can see, both of them are underlined with red. So I'm planning to click on this and then to surround with try catch, right? So surround with try catch, and then what I'm going to do is to have something like this, right? So let's have it like this. More than this, as you can see, again, I have a light bulb. This is the class not found, and I want to add exception, add catch clause, the second option. And always, most likely, when I'm working with SQL, with JDBC, I may have a SQL exception. Here, class not found exception is for this statement from line number 10. Okay. Good. Give me a few seconds. Okay. So we have this try catch, as you can see in here. Now, let's move forward. And when I'm moving forward, I'm saying the following. I'm setting for this object connection C, I'm setting to have auto commit false. C dot set auto commit false. I need to create myself the commit. Okay. And then in order to not forget, I would say C dot close. Okay. Once I have it this, between the opening of the connection to the database and closing, I'm planning to create a DB table for this. So create DB table, passing as a parameter C. Of course, I do not have these functions. I'm going to create them. Okay, so I'm creating the table. I'm inserting data, select data. So we are going to do main things by using this. Okay, and what main things? Create data, put the information into the table, into the database, and select data, and eventually then to delete the table. Is no issue to have this. Now let's focus to create these methods. First of all, I'm going to create CRUD operations, right? So first let me put only the signature, so something like public, right? Static void. And then I will have this. And then saying here connection and I have begin statement and end statement. Then the same, I'm going to copy this, even I leave them for a while empty. So I'm copy this and you see I have yet another three functions, another two actually, in total three, the one that we want to implement today together. All right. So I need the insert data and I need select data. Right now the program is going to compile, but I'm not happy because of this, because of line statement number 10. Class for name org SQLite JDBC, Java Database Connectivity. This must be a class and I should download it. I must upload it from the storage to random access memory within my Java process. This is what I'm going to do. But then I have to correct identify the library, the Java library, or even the module. If I'm working with modules, in our case, the library, the jar library, jar archive, which is containing this. And as I have told you, most of, I mean, all of the database vendors, they are providing jars, Java archives, in order to work with their database, including SQLite. And for this, I'm going to provide to you in chat a very specific link from where I would really like to download the library and to create a folder lib and to put that library into there. Let me give you the link right now. And all of us just go in there and let's download this from Chrome or whatever browser you are using. So allow me please to go into the chat, right? So in chat in here, and to everyone, I'm going to paste, please download that SQLite JDBC 3.7.2. So I'm leaving Andy to go in Chrome to show to us how it's going in Chrome. Paste that link address. And once it's pasted in the browser, the jar should be downloaded, right? So saving the file, please save it on the desktop or whatever, wherever you want. In downloads is good. It's good in downloads. I don't care. So you save it in there. And we are going to copy immediately. Give me a few seconds. Immediately, I'm going to show. So first of all, please download this jar. If you are right-click on this jar, okay, you put it in the desktop. Okay, then it's fine. Okay, please right-click on this jar or allow me please to right-click on it. And then I'm planning to open with for instance, WinRAR or 7-zip, doesn't matter, right? So let me show you what I have in here. So I have org, as you can see. I have SQLite, and in here I have my class. You see, I have a lot of code, including in native C. I have my class JDBC also in the source code, if you are curious. Also, the bytecode. Most of the vendors are offering to me only bytecode, right? And even obfuscated, I cannot decompile. So therefore, in this package, as you can see, org, SQLite, JDBC, this is the class I want to address in Eclipse. So right now, all I have to do is to put this jar into the lib folder of my project and to add to my project this jar. So switching back to Eclipse, please. Okay, switching back. What I'm going to do, let's do it together step by step. So I'm going into this project, first of all, and left click, right click, I'm going to create a folder, which is called lib. And this folder lib, I don't want to use it for sources. So I'm not going, if I'm clicking on advanced, is use default location, and I'm not saying link to alternate location of the source code. No, use default location, finish. So this is the lib folder. Of course, in this moment is empty. What I'm going to do, I'm going to left click on it, right click, and then I'm saying show in give me System Explorer, this option, System Explorer. So in here, I'm seeing exactly the path where our colleagues is working in F, Eclipse, Eclipse Workspace. This is the project. And finally here, I have the lib. What I'm going to do, I'm going to select desktop. I'm going to select the jar that is just downloaded, something like SQLite, right? So not SQL developer, but this one. In order to clean up the desktop, right click, I'm going to cut it, not leave it in there. And when I'm getting back from the desktop, I'm in this lib and I'm going with paste in here. So long story short, I created a lib folder inside my project. I copied from where I downloaded from downloads or from the desktop, whatever. I have copied this archive, SQLite JDBC version 3.7.2 jar, where I have shown you the most important thing into it is actually this class I'm referring to. And all I have to do right now is to associate this library to my project. So it's not enough if I'm going in this project and left click, right click, going with refresh F5, is not enough that I'm seeing inside the lib this jar in here. It's totally not enough. All I have to do is to right click and to associate to this project via properties to this project, the library. And what I'm going to do in the properties of the project after I have copy paste, right? All I have to do is to go into Java build path. And here in the third tab of libraries or whatever tab it is, right? Not in the module path, right? Because I don't want to work with modules. In the class path, because I'm working with traditional standard Java archive library. So in the class library, I'm simply clicking on the first button in here, add jars, add Java archive. right? So this is the way I'm adding a library. Doesn't matter is, for instance, deep learning 4J, where I have a lot of neural networks to use in Java, or is this Oracle jar that is connecting me, is helping me to connect to Oracle database, or here a SQLite or whatever other library. So this is the way I'm doing, no matter what. So I'm adding SQLite, and in this moment I have it this, apply and close. And if I did correctly, in this moment, I would have this option in here, reference library, and till now I did not have it, right? Is referring, yeah, reference library, is referring my jar. And of course, as you can see in here, in org SQLite, of course, I have JDBC class. This one from here is clear for everybody. I'm waiting a little bit for it. But most likely is no problem. It should not be issues in here, right? So please let me know if you encounter any problem. Otherwise, we are moving forward because we have a lot to do. Okay. Good. If there are no problems into this, and I have this reference library, and this is important, please understand that I'm doing what? I'm loading that class into random access memory via reflection, and using from the driver manager class, static method get connection, in the end of the day, this method is collaborating, is cooperating with get connection from JDBC. So it's a matter of this class to handle these URL strings, so universal resource locator strings, and is saying, you want to create a test.db binary file where I put your data and your tables, all of them. I have only one file, test.db, and I'm referring to you for, in order to use SQL 92 instructions and commands, I'm referring to this via this bridge, JDBC, Java Database Connectivity, SQLite. This being said, I have created the connection. For this connection, whatever I'm doing, insert into, update, delete, whatever, I'm going to set auto commit false. So for after each commands I'm sending, I need to commit, right? So now we are going in create table where I'm passing as a parameter only 4 bytes, the reference, the pointer of object connection C, where I have instantiated in here, right? Actually, in line number 11, statement from line number 11. So let's move forward and let's say something like this. First of all, I know for sure that I'm into a method and I either handle the exception with try catch of the SQL exception, either I'm throwing up. We have discussed this in the lecture number 5 or 6. So I'm saying in here, throws, right? Throws, let me, now this being said, I can say certainly SQL exception like this. Please control space enter. As long as I'm doing this, I have to copy because each of my methods can throw SQL exception because I'm working with SQL. I'm working with JDBC, right? So again, either I'm handling try catches in here, either I'm throwing up at the upper level, because in here I already have a try catch. Depends on my, on my business requirements and my implementation. Right now, what I'm going to do? I'm going to use statement, please control space, state, wait a second, hold on. You see, is Java SQL again, yet is another interface. Yes, is another interface, and this is used proper for interfaces type in terms of standardization. Why standardization? Because once I have the connection, which is dedicated for Oracle, I have a different connection for MySQL, a different connection for PostgreSQL, another connection for my case, SQLite, another connection. I say C dot, and I'm calling non-static method create statement. So what I expect to find out? So I expect into my library, as you can see in here, to have a statement class like this, STMT, right? Which is actually implementing for real that interface, statement. This is an interface. And as long as it is implementing this interface, for sure must provide to me the create statement. Doesn't matter is native implemented in C++ language or in another language like Java, Kotlin, doesn't matter. Should implement this method, and at that level of the library, I'm going to obtain the statement which is over the connection to my database. What I'm planning to do in here, I'm planning to create actually the database. So therefore, if I want to create it, I'm going to say something like this. So string, for instance, SQL create here table, right? And then I'm saying, yes, I need a string, a SQL string, doesn't matter, like create. For the moment, I'm putting blah, blah in here, dots, dots, dots. Of course, it does not exist, this string. I'm going to, but I want to not lose the picture of the skeleton of the architecture. And then I'm coming back to this string. Right now, once I have the statement obtained from the connection, all I have to do, and I have explained in the lecture, is to call non-static method execute update. Execute update. Again, for all the comments, doesn't matter are the comments in the database of the commands of manipulating data or creating tables, I'm using execute update. Only once I'm calling, instead of this method execute update, execute query. Only once, when I'm doing select. Select from whatever table with a where clause, right? Where whatever ID is less than 30 or age is equals with 35 or whatever, right? So wherever I'm creating a select and I need a cursor, I need a statement like a result set. Therefore, I'm using execute query. Otherwise, anytime, absolutely anytime, I'm going to use execute update. Here I have this. And is saying what is this object? Is not this, is this string. And of course, at the moment of the compile, this is not sent to the engine of the database. In our case is not sent to that jar which is playing the role of the database engine in the same time, not only of the client library. So is not sent to this. That's why my compilation is fine. But I'm coming back to this to in order to do a proper SQL 92 statement in here, right? Leave it for the moment like this. So I have executed this for create table, and then I have to close the statement in order to not forget, close. And please be aware, I'm not going to close the connection. Connection I'm going to close only in the end. So please pay attention, because when you are connecting to the Oracle database in TCP/IP port, actually TCP 1521, right? In there, by default, if you are not configuring otherwise, Oracle is exposing 10 TCP connections to its own engine. So do not fool around with creating connection for every, I don't know, loop or whatever, every statement in your code. So please use carefully the connections. You don't have a lot of them. Of course, you can configure to have 100 connections. But this means the Oracle database is going to use in multi-tenancy mode with the fork of the process and multi-threading in behind in order to handle instead of 10 concurrent connections, 100, which means a lot of hardware resources consumed, right? And this means, again, pay attention, when you are paying licenses for Oracle database, for instance, you are paying per CPU core usage, right? So if you have multi-threads, instead of using only one CPU core, you are going to use all CPU cores, let's say four. And you are going to pay $10,000, for instance, for each core. And I'm not kidding. This is the average you are paying. So $40,000 if you are running database like Oracle on multiple multi-threading in a system with a CPU in your machine with four CPU cores. Good. This being said, we are moving forward and we are saying just like this. After this, I need commit, because if you remember, I said my connection by default, by design, is going to have auto-commit false. Now let's finalize this. What I want to create here, a table, and therefore the database is automatically created in here, TestDB. This is the database. It's a little bit awkward. I mean, it's database between quotes. It's not a real database. It's a Berkeley indexed file where, of course, via this jar library, I can work with SQL 92. Now, hold on. If I want to work with an Oracle database, I'm going to modify these two strings, only this and this. The entire code remains the same. This is the power of JDBC. This is the power of interfaces type and standardization that I have explained to you in the first lectures. Now coming back in, so all other statements are staying like this. So I'm going to create the table, and now it's going to be much more fun. Table, company. And please be aware, company. And please be aware, there are engines which depends also how you are installing and configure them. But for instance, my SQL is a database engine which is case sensitive. So for instance, if you are calling a table in MySQL like this, small c and all other letters capital, When you are going with the select in the MySQL client, right? Select all from company. If you not put small c, you are going to receive an error. So please be aware, most of the engines of the databases can be configured to be case sensitive at the name of the tables and at the name of the columns, right? So I'm creating the table company, and in here I'm going to say the following. So round parenthesis, open, round parenthesis, closed. And when I'm pressing enter, automatically you see was nice enough in here, the IDE, the Eclipse IDE, to create the concatenation of strings. And I want to have the ID, identification of one company, which is int primary key, right? And this primary key, I prefer to be not null. And then comma, and moving forward, I need the name of the employee inside this company to be a text, right? Which is not null. Hold on. This is a problem yet again, because if we are working, for instance, with Oracle database, most likely in here you would have something like varchar2, right? Or something like this. So this is somehow dependent by the database you are working with. So yes, it's SQL, yes, it's portable, but please be aware, if you have PL SQL text in here, of course that one is going to work only on Oracle. If you modify a little bit, it's going to work very nicely on PostgreSQL, but still there are slight modifications you have to do. So please be aware, when you are working SQL, this SQL text to be compliant with the engine of your database. But otherwise, if you are using compliant, fully compliant, only SQL language standard, then is working again for over the same statement over a lot of database engine like engines like Oracle, MySQL, SQL Server, or whatever. Now let's move forward. So I had the name. I need the age, could be null, is an int, you know. Also, I can discuss about somebody is having age 21 and a half, but leave it like this, leave it like int. Then I'm going to put the address. The address, of course, in here, in English, I'm going to keep it address. Could be a char of maximum 50 letters. And now again, depends of the encoding. If you are configuring, I'm discussing about large databases. If you are configuring your database for real, let's take a little bit discussion. So if you are configuring the database for real, for instance, for each letter, to be stored in a universal text format on 16 bits little endian or big endian, UETF-16LE or BE, right? Then each letter is going to be on 2 bytes. So in here you have 50 letters. But in our case, in SQLite, actually we have also 50 bytes. So this was the address. And finally, the salary is a float. But here in SQLite, the salary, if it's a float, we are going to put in SQL something like real. Real number, right? Okay, and then that's it. I'm not putting semicolon because by default SQL knows to submit this command in here that you have seen is submitted in here. Let's move forward and let's insert several things into our database. So this has been created, then it's fine. Each time I have to be careful that is creating this file. And automatically, once this file is creating, the DB table, actually immediately this company table is going to be created. Now, once I have created into it, I'm planning to do what? To insert data into it. So therefore, I'm moving forward and I'm saying in here, fine, very well, I'm planning to insert. And once I'm planning to insert this, I'm going to do something like this. So let's create this statement, right? ST equals null, and then I'm using the string SQL text actually equals also null. Then it's fine, and I would have something like ST equals with C dot create statement. You already got this, okay? And in order to not forget, then I have to do what? I have to be aware to not forget st dot, for instance, close, right? And therefore, I'm moving forward. I would say c dot commit. Fine. So let's create this, and I'm going to say in here, okay, my SQL text is going to be something like this. Insert, between quotes, of course, is a text also. Semicolon. Okay, so I'll say insert into, again, the SQL statements are not case sensitive, but the name of the tables, the name of the database, and eventually of the columns depends on my configuration. And usually most of the database engines are supporting to be case sensitive. So therefore I'm inserting in the table with name company with capital letters. So company in here, right? So I'm planning to have in this, yes, I want to insert the, for the column ID, name, and then age, and then address, and then salary. I'm planning to insert this with values. And finally here, again, this is not case sensitive, space. And for these values, I'm going to, for instance, say between parentheses like this, and then enter. I would say the values for real. So please pay attention. ID is an integer. So I would say one. This is first. I'm hard coding. The name is a text. I'm going to put between simple quotes. I'm going to say here, I don't know, George. Right? Then I'm moving forward and I'm saying the age, 23 or whatever, 22 or whatever. Then the address between quotes, because it's again text. I can put a large address, but not larger than 50 letters. I'm going to put B from Bucharest, Romania, right? And then the salary, let's say 21,000, yes, lei or US dollars, how you prefer. Okay, so I have this, and therefore I don't want to forget to execute this. So I'll say st dot, for instance, execute update, execute, not batch. This is a, yet another thing, execute update. And in here, yes, I need to run this SQL to execute this SQL text, right? Insert into. And then in order to not forget, I had the ST close and then commit. But let's move forward and to put into a mirror in how to say, okay, let me put it this way. So give me a few moments. Good. So let me put here the prepare statement. So this was the statement, and I'm going to explain into the lecture. I have explained into the lecture, but I'm going to explain it on Friday for you. What is the difference? Not in this, only in the syntax. Okay, syntax is important, but I want to understand what is the difference in behind, and that difference applies. Doesn't matter you are programming in C#.NET or you are programming in Python or PHP or whatever other platform language. So doesn't matter where you are programming, is a totally difference between statement and prepared statement. Allow me please to create a prepared statement. So prepared, S, capital S, ST, control space, please end it. Thank you very much. And here I would have PS from prepare statement as an object. Let me show you. PS, right? So equals with C dot, is working slower, I think. Okay, that's why I want to, okay, thanks. So C dot, and then I'm going to call non-static method instead of, no, I'm going to, yeah, okay. Instead of prepare state, okay, I have prepare statement, not create statement, right? So prepare statement. And in here, I'm going to put directly between quotes my prepared statement, right? And let me do it this way. So I'm going to copy, this is the same, more or less. I'm going to copy this string, I have it from here. Actually, let me copy the entire string. I have it from here because it's a difference. You will see in a bit, right? Let me copy. Maybe if you want, let me put it this way. String P prepared SQL equals, and then I'm going to copy this. And allow me please, instead of then semicolon, instead of having the values, I would have question marks. I'm going to explain in a bit. Question mark. Question mark. Question mark. So this is, I'm going to show you with Wireshark, with what is traveling in the network, but I have doubt that I have time right now. If I have time, I'm going to show you. If not, in the lecture at latest, I'm going to show you why this is more performant than this. But you already should put this question in your head. So here I have, for instance, PSQL. PSQL, all right? So this is PS. And all I have to do in here is to execute statements. So I would say, for instance, ps.executeUpdate. Execute update, because it's an insert, right? Good. But because it's prepared, I have to put for these prepared question marks literal values. And therefore, I know for sure first field is an ID, which is an integer. So I'm going to say ps.setInt, not set double, not set text, or not whatever else. At index one, not starting from zero, but from one, I'm going to put value two. Why? Please pay attention. I already inserted Paul with the ID one, Paul George with ID one, right here, right? So I already inserted. If I put here the value of one, it's going to be duplicate, which is not normal. It's going to crash with an exception because ID is primary key, not null, so cannot be duplicate. It's a primary key, and you know very well from the database lectures, right? So it must be different, right? So as long as my must be different, I have to prepare the statements in here. So let me put it this way. So I have ps dot, moving forward, set string. Now I'm moving to text, right? And this is column two. And for this second column, I'm going to put the name between quotes, normal quotes, right? I'm going to put the name John. Moving forward, I have a prepared statement, dot, and then I have a set int, right? So parameter index, I have 3, and then I have 23, is the age of this John. It's a little bit older. And move forward, finally, I'm going to put the address. Address is text again. So again, set string, right? And here is the index of my column 4. Please number it. 1, 2, 3, 4 is the address, right? And for the address, instead of being from Bucharest, is from Brasov, right? Hermannstadt. Okay, Hermannstadt is actually Sibiu. Brasov, Kronstadt. So Brasov. Okay, and then moving forward, finally, is the salary, which is a real number in our case in Java, and in C sharp is a float, right? So is ps dot, for instance, set float, right? And then parameter index is finally 5, and this is the salary, is a little bit lower, right? Is, I don't know, let's put 5,000, right? So this has been the prepared statement. Let me put it in here. I have created the prepared statement. Now I have replaced the question marks in terms of syntax with these real values by index of the column, and then I'm executing this. If I need to insert yet another row, yes, I'm going to do it. So I'm not going to create again a PS. I'm leaving like this. And in order to not forget, let me put it in here, enter, and I have it in here, for instance, PS.close, right? Close, sorry. Control space, close, right? So I have something like this. So what I'm saying is, if yet I want to create another row inside my table and to insert it again, I'm not going to create the prepared statement. I'm just going to reuse it. And of course, to pay attention what value I'm putting. I have already as a primary key in ID value 1 and 2, I'm putting 3. You know, instead of, I can leave John again, but is a different person. Let's assume I'm talking about David. He's a different age, 25 years old. He is from Iași, IS. And finally in here, I'm going to have something like, I don't know, 8,000. Right. So I have created and I have inserted one with normal statement, one row. And here I have inserted two rows inside my table, right? Inside my table company with prepare statement. Please do not forget to close the prepare statement and to do the commit in the end of the day. And now finally, all I want to do, because the time is ticking right now, right? Finally, I want to do what? I want to select and to see everything I did is correct, right? So because I want to do this, I'm going to say, finally, the last one, statement, S or ST or whatever, the name of the object, it's up to me, right? C, what I'm receiving as a parameter, dot create statement again. Okay, and in order to not forget, I would have st.close. The connection is closed in the end of the main method, public static void main. Now, let's think about it in here. I want to see that what I have inserted is good enough. So if I want to see, I can create, for instance, a string of SQL selection or whatever I want to call this here. And I'm simply saying, look, I want to select all the fields from company, case sensitive, be aware. And eventually I'm leaving like this, or I have told you, eventually I can replace this SQL select with a where clause, where age is less than, I don't know, 20. Well, it's up to me how I'm doing this. But let's assume I'm going to see all of them. And of course, you can put it in here, for instance, where, but I'm going to delete. Age, for instance, is less than 23, or whatever I want to achieve. Right, in terms of relational algebra into my relational database with quotes or not. So I have this select, and please pay attention. In this moment, my statement is only once, when instead of execute update, I would have something like execute query, right? This is the only for the select statement, I must use execute query, SQL select. And this is for sure, when I'm reading the documentation, is going to return to me an object from class result set. So result S, control space. Result set, you see, is yet another interface. And I'm putting here RS, right? Allow me. RS, right? RS, whatever name I want to do it, to put it, is equal with. Right, with st.execute query. So execute query is from statement, which is an interface. Result set is an interface. Actually, the dirty job in behind is done by the classes from that jar of the database. In my case, SQLite, but could be MySQL, could be SQL Server from Microsoft, could be Postgre, could be Oracle database, whatever database. So I'm creating and I'm obtaining what you call it cursor is actually the result set. And therefore, I'm planning myself to display on the screen this result set without user interface. I can have, of course, user interface in here. So I would say while rs.next is doing two things. First of all, is moving the cursor of the database on the current record. Second of all, if is not, I mean, even if it's the last record, is moving the cursor for the next to the next record. If the next record does not exist, it means my table finished, end of table. If does exist, then I would have the next one and the next one and the next one. And what I'm going to do in here, look, I'm getting into, let's say, local variables, which means on the stack of this method, I'm going to extract the ID. So int ID equals from my result set, line by line, going record by record inside my table. And I want to get in here, I know for sure, the ID is an int. And I'm getting either by column index, either by the name of the column. In my case, ID. Please pay attention. I want to avoid any problems. SQLite is not case sensitive in terms of the name of the columns. But I want to avoid anything. And I would say ID because wherever I have created my table, I use capital letters, right? So I want to avoid anything. I want to be case sensitive into this to avoid any unpleasant surprise. So then semicolon, I finish this. I'm moving forward and I would say, yes, I would need, for instance, string name, which equals with rs dot, right? And in here, I would have, for instance, get string. And here I rather prefer to instead use the column number I would use to see different things. Column name, which is actually name. And in order to avoid anything, I would say name with capital letters. Then move forward and I need the age. So int age equals, right, with rs.getInt Okay, good, int. And here I would say between quotes the name of my column, which is h, right? So let's move forward. And then I want to get the salary and the salary and the address. So string addr equals rs.getString. I know for sure is a string. And here instead of column index, again, the name is addresses, address. And finally, the last one is the float, for instance, salary, cell, whatever. And I know for sure, look, salary, whatever. Right. So then I have rs, get float, in order to see different data types. That's why I put it like this. And here, for sure, with capital letters, I would have salary. Then it's fine. I took it all the fields, all the values for each column, for each row, row by row, row by row. So the only thing I want to do right now is to display this on the screen. So system.out.println, right, to go line by line for each statement inside my result set. I'm saying, okay, I want to see it line by line in here. So backslash n is not necessary eventually, this print line, as long as I have backslash n, it's up to me, right? So let's use it like this, a printf, because it's much more easier for me to do the format like in C language. So ID, I am between quotes. ID equals, and I know this is a integer, percentage escape decimal, so percent D, comma. I want to see the name, which for sure this is a string, so percent S. Then I move forward, and if I'm moving forward, the next I want to display is the age, right, equals, and this is again yet a percent D. Then comma, then I need the address, which this is again a percent S. And then finally, I would have the salary with capital S. Whatever, this is a text, I can display whatever I want, right? Salary, okay. And then in here, this is a percent F, right? It's float, right? And then finally, I would have what? I would have separated with comma a real value for each escape sequence, like this percent D, percent S, and so on. So I'm moving forward, and I would say yes, for that, I need the ID, for instance. Then look, this one from here, line by line, I'm getting the ID. Then the next one, the second one is name, is variable object name, which is from class string. Then age, then address, ADDR. And then finally, I wanted to say cell, but I, in the end of the day, put it salary, and that's it, right? So after I finalize this, while I'm pretty sure my result set is in the end of its own record. So I would say after this while, rs result set object dot non-static method close. Right. So that's it, right? So this is the, if you want to see it better, this is the end of while, and this is the end of method, and method, whatever, select, and this is the end of the class, right? So I have something like this, and I'm going to save it, class. Right now, I'm going to save it. And if I have time, I'm going to show you different things for sure, including what I have told you into the lecture, or I'm going to tell you about the what is the difference between prepared statement and real statement. So in this moment, I'm ready. I'm saving this, and the only thing I want to do is to left click on this, for instance, right click, right? And then is run as Java application. And when I'm running, I prepare to see that my DB file has been created, look in here, right? If I want to run one more time, I have to delete it, why? Because I did not do the drop table, right? So I cannot create table company infinitely into this same test DB. This test DB, by the way, is a very small one. That's why I use it in Android and so on. It is indexed very well. And if I want to have a third party application which is whatever, let's say, displaying something for me, because I want to double check. I do not, let's say, rely only what I did on Java. Yes, I have created the table. Yes, I have inserted into it. And yes, I have obtained those three statements from here. I mean, three rows, which is my table, then it's for sure okay. But I am, I want to see that with a different program is working the same. So therefore, please let's go. You have already a DB browser, right? SQLite. If I'm opening this SQLite and I'm going to not new database, but to open database, even in read-only mode, right? So I'm going to go in F. Would you be so kind to go into the Eclipse project where I have TestDB, you know better than me, in Eclipse, I think, Eclipse. And yes, you have, yes, thank you very much. Yes, thank you. So as you can see in here, I have table company that I have created in Java. And this company, if I'm going into browse data, yes, I'm seeing what I have inserted into my database. So my program is totally correct. So whatever I did is totally correct. This is I want to see. I do not expect everybody of you to have this SQL DB browser, which is yet a good program on Windows, right? This is a third-party program to validate that what I did is correct, right? So let's move forward and say, okay, I need to see each one of you that is working correctly. But before doing this, Andy, would you be so kind to let's go in online? I'm stopping this because of GDPR. I'm stopping recording. This is SQLite Berkeley indexed file format, binary text with the information. And the information is not encrypted, it's in clear.